You see us, huh? Hello? Friendly Dargoles, can you imagine? Whoops. Who dat? Fampyr. At the center of this massive address structure, beneath the long shadow of the Titan's curled fingers, sits what appears to be a man. Appears to be. Unlike the slavering animalistic creatures you have encountered in this floor, the man is regally composed, lounging upon a crooked stone throne, yet his gaze has a piercing, feverish quality. He watches you intently as you approach. What are you, then? One of theirs? Strange that you survived the planning stages. He speaks in fluid Ingwithin, you note, though his voice is taut with strain. It must have been hard for them, those beggars, those cowards. But you won't go any farther. No, you can go right on back to them, your masters. Let them feast on you instead. I don't know what you're talking about. Kanna says, ah, you can understand him? Ask him everything. What an opportunity. The man looks startled. He gives a short laugh. You understand. Look here. Even the foreigners speak our tongue now. Truly, we are an immortal people. He laughs again. But that only makes it all the more clear, you see. You must be with them. How have they kept you so whole? You're remarkably well preserved. His eyes narrow. Attempt to pass, and you will go screaming back into the void, puppet. You're Ingwithin. How is it you're still alive? Oh, no, no, no. We do not share information with our enemies. Go and ask the others. See if they recall. If they remember who it was that sustained us all these years. Who are you? Lord and master of this place. He raps his knuckles on the throne. I should ask you the same. By all rights, you're trespassing. But then our great father is long gone. Perhaps he won't mind. If you're talking about the creatures in those old rooms, I've already dealt with them. Ha! Good. Very good. He touches a hand to his mouth, brows knitting, and then laughs. Yes, it's all mine now. No more of their screaming. No need for any more pointless demonstrations of power. Okay, sorry, guys. Go on, then. Go barreling down into the deep, if you like. If the beetles don't make a quick end of you. Beetles? Voracious little devils. They're what caused this whole mess. You can kill one easily enough, but there's a great swarm of them chewing through the Adra. My Adra. There's only the arm now. Yeah, I just wanted to see him explain these beetles to us. In any case, they'll tear you apart just as easily as they do the crystals. He pauses. More easily. I had some questions first. Yes, yes. I said you could have some answers. What is it? Who are you? Did you want a name? I forgot those ages ago. Who's going to call me anything down here? There's me, and now there's just you. That's all that matters. I was entrusted with the tests we performed here. The foremost, he taps his temple, mind of the age. None could rival me for arcane powers save Adnua himself. He pauses, and perhaps some of his advisors. What was this place? Oh, many things. Our home, once, and before that, a place of great deeds. He chuckles. Those foul chambers in there were once the site of incredible discoveries. We were given the bulk of this floor. There was construction, at all hours, of course. He gestures toward the Adra arm. For all of our work was, of course, for Adnua's purposes. Think of it. A dozen sculptors carefully crafting a fingernail, souls flung from their shells on the floors and below, all the while Idros fusses over a cuticle. What kind of experiments were you doing? Why, we were preoccupied with matters of the soul. All of us were, because Adnua was. But here we toiled to find the dividing line between life and death and crack it wide open. were attempting to find a means of binding souls to their mortal vessels, preventing them from crossing the shroud. I say attempting. We found it, of course. A dozen minds set to purpose. How could we not? The things we learned! What a glorious time. We could determine the precise manner into which a soul would crack and shatter, could carefully place a fragment from one into another. He smiles at the memory. While our fellows wasted their efforts on phenomena like blights, we delved right into the heart of the matter. There were certain gaps in our knowledge, of course. I was perhaps enthusiastic in my pursuits. I thought that if anyone should attempt a more personal approach to the tests, it should be me. And no amount of certainty will make the imbibing of poison a pleasant experience. Death is the ultimate test, you see. If the soul has flown, then you know you've failed. Your work sounds similar to animancy.
Like what?
He shrugs. Perhaps others follow in our steps. I have not had the opportunity to keep up with the state of magical study. He smiles thinly. How have you stayed alive all this time? The big question. Binding a soul to its body was not, it turned out, very difficult. We were certain we'd found a kind of immortality. The body could be destroyed beyond repair, but anything else is quite survivable. Survivable. I was eager to attempt it. My leg, at the time, pained me terribly, old war wound, and I had heard one subject describe a sense of distance from the pain inflicted upon them. They felt it, but it didn't matter to them, which would be a vast improvement. I remember the first moment, the relief. But we found that after some time the body would remember that it was, after all, dead. There's really no describing what it feels like to see your own fingers rotting away. He makes a face. The smell. We tried to revive the affected subjects with energy coal from their fellows, and it worked well enough. I was able to refine the spellwork, keep myself and the others who had joined me as hale as ever. Adnua wasn't terribly pleased with the distraction, but that turned out not to matter. The mob came and murdered him, and we were sealed in here with the rest of his tools. But we still had the Adra, you see, and enough souls housed in there to feed us for, well, as long as we wished. And so, he grins, we had a time of it, we did. We were able to preserve the furniture over the years. We had little meetings in our grand chamber. What a nice little family we were. His grin fades, until it had to end. What happened here?
Here? You mean with them? The Adra? All of it?
That's a long tale, and my patience has diminished with time. I'll tell you what's happened recently. It was the Adra beetles. Oh, you wouldn't think it was something so small, so mundane, but they came swarming up from the lower reaches and started to feed upon the live Adra. I thought Adra beetles only feed on dead Adra.
Just so. They never troubled us before. Still, it happened.
We tried to fight them off, of course, but it was impossible. Kill one and two more are behind it. Something must have driven them up here. I don't know what.
Something bad enough to make them go on feed on live Adra when they really prefer dead?
They all but amputated our Adra limb. Not enough to support all of us. Not us in the rooms, the tapestries, everything. But enough for me. None of the others knew the spells required. The only part in it was simply to lie in their Adra coffins and be revived by me. So it was an obvious choice, wasn't it? No more of that. No more of anything. I swore I'd burn them all to kindling if they came near. Fortunately, you made that unnecessary.
How could you do that to your companions?
You're soft-hearted, considering it was you who put an end to their immortality. They weren't anyone's friends. They would have licked the brains out of your cracked skull if they could. There wasn't enough life to go around. That's all it was. And 2,000 years is more than long enough to get to know someone. Think on it this way. You've sent them on their way, and they will live again in time. Isn't that a comfort?
Can you tell me about Adnua?
Our great lord, a wise man in his day, until his son was lost, an accident, some small unfortunate turn of fate.
You've come but a little way past the sealed chambers. You must know by now that Adnua did not take it well. This monument to his grief has outlasted him. But his madness proved opportunity, a promise of immortality for all of us. If it was found at the behest of a grieving father, what did it matter? He had a flock of devoted servants. Well, we had to find the soul in question, to bring it back from whatever it had gone to house it somewhere suitable. He indicates the statue, and such discoveries have costs, something the rabble didn't understand. I'm looking for the master below. Do you know who that is? None of us took such grand titles. The only master of this would be Adnua, our king, our poor grief-maddened king. Oh, would he call himself such, I wonder? Adnua is dead. The mob would not have retreated without having killed him, he thinks a moment. But then if we could preserve ourselves despite our deaths, then so perhaps could he. I am sure I considered the possibility once, when it had all come crashing down. If any man would prolong himself, it would be him. I wonder, was it he who drove the Adra beetles up here from below? His face twists with anger. Who stole our Adra source? Does he mourn his son yet, the mewling fool, that he should resent our feeding upon his statue? A possibility. He regards you with sudden calm. After all this time, it wouldn't surprise me. Well, you tortured people and used their souls to prolong your own life. You don't deserve immortality. It was all for a good purpose. I'll show you once our spat is done just how malleable a soul can be. He rises from his throne. Your blood holds far more life in it than the Adra. Get the Fampyr, if we can. Cast this yet? My, my. Okay, we'll just attack him. I keep interrupting him. Oh, he's almost dead. Cool. Oh, Ken is evil. Oh boy. Why is he running? Durance? Oh my god. Well, because you ran instead of healing Aeloth, he's dead. Or unconscious, rather. Okay, now perhaps you can heal us? Oh, can you stop using that damn sword? Attack your enemy in the proper manner. Okay, she's down. Maybe we'll have time to do this. Raise. I hate to say it, raise Aeloth. Just to run over to him? Is there something wrong with Aeloth that we can't heal him or do anything to him? We run back up the. Okay, this is screwed up. Alright, screw Aeloth. We can't help him, for whatever reason. Help Durance and crew. And, bring Theodas back. You're just gonna completely stand over there. Okay, don't bring her back either. I don't know what to tell you. Maybe attack something? That'd be nice. Gotta pour on the healing, because Palagina is useless at this point. Kill this thing.
I have.
Oh no. Knock this. Kill this last one. He's almost dead. Just kill it. Thank you. Get this wizard thing.
Hey.
Ah, that was kind of close, wasn't it? Sheesh. Some big time pathing problems here.
Alright then.
Alrighty then. Ooh, unique armor in here. Argus Adra. Fine. Plus 2 damage reduction as being fine. Grants Senka chance on unconscious. Revive with 30 endurance. So he's cool. Heavy armor, though. When Gref Admeth Hadrit passed the 10 years treaties on the anniversary of the War of Black Trees, he outlawed the looting of Ingwithin ruins. While this was a popular move among the Glanfathans, as well as the frontier villagers who frequently found themselves the subject of the tribe's vengeance, it was an unwelcome change for the traders and adventurers who had made a living selling Ingwithin artifacts. Quite a few vendors, however, took to commissioning and selling replicas, Many fakes were so skillfully made that even scholars had difficulty distinguishing between them, and ciphers were sometimes hired to attest to the authenticity of high-value objects. Argus Adra, or Adra Armor, actually was taken from ruins near the Court of Bowing Ashes, but it so closely resembled two known fakes that it famously passed through Defiance Bay, and Sezi and Salona before an animancer in Barda recognized its authenticity. I think the only one wearing heavy armor is Aloth. I mean, not Aloth. Kana. Saying one name, meaning another. Sanguine Plate. Medium. 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 Light armor. Okay. Oh wait, no. Close that. I meant to hit that. Damage reduction 14, same there. Recovery speed, same. Plus 2 survival. Grants frenzy when hit by a critical hit. Well, that's what he goes into, frenzy. Second chance at unconscious. Plus 2 lore. Yeah, let's give him that. Because I never know what this, how much hit points he has left with this frenzy, and the second chance could come in really handy. I wonder how I go up in levels. Attribute bonuses. Let's give him plus 2 might. Burn proof. What was it? Look at that. All colorfuls.
I shall be discreet.
Any secrets? Can we go any higher than that? No. I don't want to do that. Try to hit tab and that happens. Oh, we got another bridge. Okay, let's go across this bridge. Oh my god, we got more. Yeah, this is a longer level. Hopefully I don't run out of space on my hard drive.
Yes?
Got
it! Mm-hmm.
Yes?
That's not very helpful.
Well, I'll just give it a try.
That's it.
That's it.
That's it.
Pack a shot, huh? That was the one we previously injured. Yes.
keeping an eye out.
Ah, stairs down. Okay, so that's the master staircase, and that's just the stairs. We're gonna go down that way. This was level 8. Stay tuned, and yeah, we'll explore level 9, and then we'll go back up and we'll do some quests and, you know, for companions and such like that. Anyway, so we'll be doing 9 first. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. And enduring, grow strong.